Hello and welcome to this week's episode of The Winning Post. I'm Andira Lalwani. Here we are in Pune for the Kingfisher Ultra Pune Derby. After the Indian Derby and then the Bangalore Derby, Kingfisher Ultra has now taken the Pune Derby to new heights. And here is what this episode is all about.
Accolade won Kunigal Stud, the distinction of its 100th win. And it's only fitting that the same horse would bring the stud farm glory by winning the Kingfisher Ultra Pune Derby last weekend. The race had all the ingredients for a thriller, and what a thriller it was, providing a perfect end to Pune's biggest racing weekend. More on that later, but first let's take a look at Kingfisher Ultra and its contribution to horse racing. Traditionally, the Pune Derby weekend is held in conjunction with the IGCC Oktoberfest, and this year too, tradition was followed to the T. Saturday, 15th October, marked the beginning of the action, with plenty happening on and off the track. There were fierce battles on the track and singing, dancing, celebration and a commingling of cultures off it. Kingfisher Ultra is a brand that signifies style and glamour. It is a brand that fits in with all that a derby stands for perfectly well. This synergy between the brand and three of India's topmost races spells a new dawn for Indian racing sponsorship. Racing sponsorship in India is leagues behind its international counterparts. Internationally, racing has major sponsors that have been associated with the race for many, many years. In India, sponsors don't exactly make a beeline for the sport that is considered too niche. It, however, looks like Kingfisher Ultra is set to change that, with three of India's biggest races, the Kingfisher Ultra Indian Derby, the Kingfisher Ultra Bangalore Derby, and now the Kingfisher Ultra Pune Derby, the brand's dominance is obvious for all to see. While this association is in its first year, there is hope that it will continue for years to come. And more importantly, also set a precedent for other bigger names to consider putting their weight behind a sport that in India is yet to see the kind of patronage that cricket or football receive.
First year as a sponsor of this race, and quite clearly, the Ultra presence is being felt across the horse racing industry.
Well, we hope so. This is a platform that we've decided to appropriate for the brand. And Ultra is positioned on fashion and style. And what is more fashionable and stylish than the Derby? So it's been a good and interesting journey. We have got Bombay, we have Bangalore, we have Pune now. And let's see, we're looking at more such sort of interventions.
And a great event here, the Oktoberfest, of course, part of the Derby celebration. You enjoy yourself there?
Yes, absolutely. I think it's a great value add to what we're doing. Full credit to Peter and the German Chamber of Commerce, who have run this brilliant event for so many years. And I think the team here worked very well with your team to really integrate both events to come together and give people a lovely ultra experience.
The first edition of the Kingfisher Ultra Pune Derby Group 1 saw 11 three-year-olds enter the parade ring for the contest to be run over 2,000 metres. All eyes were trained on the pacey Shroff Charge Accolade, who was coming into the contest on the back of a win in the Deccan Colts Championship Stakes in Hyderabad. And though he had refused to be stalled and had to consequently be withdrawn from the Deccan Derby, he held enough promise for the markets to back him, towering head and shoulders above the rest of the field. Trevor Patel rode him for the occasion. His rival in the race was the Vishal Gaikwad trained Germanicus, who was coming into the contest on the back of a win in the Group 3 SA Poonawalla Multimillion, holding off Silken Eyes, and looked like one who could pose a threat to Accolade. He was ridden by A. Sandesh. His stablemate Covert Action was coming into the race still a maiden and was making his first group appearance. He would find it tough with a field that was far more experienced than him. NS Parmar partnered him in the saddle. The Narendra Lagat trained Iger's Tiger won his last start over 1,800 metres. But this for him, like Covert Action, would be a tall ask. Dashrath Singh held his reins. Highland Breeze from Rehanullah Khan's yard had proved his staying ability in a Class 3 over 1,800 metres that he landed with ease. Yet he does not possess the class the other horses have, especially with Accolade in the field, and will be looking at proving himself here with P.S. Chauhan in the saddle. Namit from Neel Darashah's yard came in as a final entry all the way across from Bangalore. He ran third in the Mysore 2000 Guineas behind Sergeant at Arms, which is no mean feat, and looked like one who would pick up the minor placing here with Suraj Naredu piloting him. Smart and Noble, trained by Kartik Ganpati, had run fourth in a Class 3 over 1,600 meters and would have to give it his all here. He would be ridden by Bhavani Singh. The two fillies in the field were Silken Eyes and Unforgettable You. Unforgettable You, trained by Malesh Naredu, won her debut in the Pune Mira Salva over 1,400 meters in good fashion but lacks the experience. She would be ridden by Y.S. Srinath. Silken Eyes, trained by Kuji Katrak, had run second to Germanicus in the SA Poonawalla Multimillion and would now be looking at reversing the form on him with Neeraj Rawal on board once again. The remainder of the field had Vulcan, trained by Adhiraj Singh Joda, and Zanzibar from Nirat Karanjawala's yard, both of whom had their work cut out for them. The energy in the air was palpable as the horses made their way to the starting gates. With the starter's orders, the cheers reached a deafening crescendo.
And they're away and they're racing for the inaugural running of the Kingfisher Ultra Pune Derby, even dispatched from the gate by all the runners. And as the field settles down past the 1800 meter marker, we find Accolade in front, being tracked on the outside there by Vulcan going ahead now, 3.5 lengths behind us. Nabbit in the Claret and Gold is the only outstation challenger at the past the 1600 meter marker. Very close behind us, Germanicus on the outside, sporting the white cap, has got two of two. Iger's Tiger in the white and brown is hugging the rails, length and a half behind is Highland Breed. Smart and Noble in the golden brown is hugging the rails to pass the 1400, past the St. Patrick's Cathedral. Length and a half behind is Silken Eyes in the light and dark blue. After that is Zanzibar, covert action, second last, last of four. Another 2.5 lengths behind as the pass to 1200 is Unforgettable You, the daughter of Arazan. They're heading towards the halfway stage now with the Vulcan is the leader. Bang! In second there is Accolade, the son of Burden of Proof. Another 2.5 lengths behind is the Namid in third, being tracked on the outside, 3/4 of a length behind. There is covert action, Iger's Tiger on the outside. Germanicus making a quick forward move. So do his Highland Breeze, and they're Smart and Noble past the half a mile pole. Silken Eyes is not too far away. Then the Zanzibar, covert action, and Unforgettable You. They're running down to the entrance of the home stretch. It's Vulcan is the leader, being chased all the time by Accolade. Iger's Tiger being pushed in third. Then there's Namir has gone for the stick. After that is Germanicus making a forward move. Then there's Silken Eyes as a hedge turn for home. Round the turn and into the straight, it's a Vulcan comes in home first from Accolade is the one moving up nicely on the outside. 4 lengths behind is Germanicus, but Vulcan is now being pressed on the outside there by Accolade. Accolade with a crack or two. Vulcan has dropped the rider. Then there's Germanicus. There can't be a better tribute than this to the sire. Burden of Proof. Accolade does it in the Pune Derby from Germanicus. Namid is only third ahead of Silken Eyes. Then there's Highland Breeze, Zanzibar, Smart and Noble, covert action. Then there's Iger's Tiger, last of all is Unforgettable You.
Accolade looked all set to add the Pune Derby to his kitty as he made a dash for the wire. At the 200 meter marker, however, he shifted in and tightened the Adhiraj Singh Joda trained Vulcan, who was racing along the rails. This caused Vulcan to clip Accolade's heels, thereby causing him to stumble and dislodge his rider. Accolade finished his conquest and was first past the post. The incident, however, led to a stewards' room inquiry, which had everyone on the edge of their seats.
Well, he got a nice soft lead and he'd switched off. He's very relaxed, so actually there was no cause for worry at all. I mean, he's really switched off and relaxed if you look at him. It was a little worrying when he jumped out and got to the front, but you know, it was nice that somebody took it off him.
I think that was just his class telling right from the gate.
Yeah, probably.
You know what the verdict is? Because I think it looked like four or five lengths. And not surprisingly, Germanicus has run second, Namit third. It looks like the classic crop is holding its form this year.
Right. I really wasn't looking at the second.
Okay, that was Zen Mirza. We're taking a look at the race right now. Accolade in second in the red cap.
A lot of them already under pressure there. Well before the bend, a lot of them are scrubbing and under pressure.
Yeah, he looked a winner at the top of the turn.
And it's a good thing that he switched out. I mean, because that horse finally ultimately came down. Yeah. I don't know what happened there. It's a good thing he wasn't following him at that stage. You see, just here. just as he passes him. What happens, I don't know.
He tends to lug in a bit, doesn't he?
He does. But he's looked like more than 4 or 5 lengths, I think. He's done it in a canter.
But all is well that ends well. The stewards decided to maintain the order of placing as declared by the judge, and Accolade was declared the Pune Derby champion.
Trevor, really well done. Take us through the race. You jumped into an early position. You surprised us at all. Were you surprised, or was that always the plan?
I was not surprised. He's very quick out of the gates usually, and he showed his similar pace what he does always. And I was in the front. There was no pace. Luckily, I got a front runner. I was just following him. Came into his chair, picked up, and he won well. Won very well.
All right, big question. We all know he's brilliant over a mile. We know he's won over a mile and a quarter. The big question, mile and a half in the Winter Classics, Indian Derby.
Oh, we'll get to know in winter only. It's difficult.
All right, very diplomatic, but very well done.
The winning honours were given away in front of the grandstand, and Accolade is now being regarded as one of the top 3 3-year-olds in the country. And this race has proved beyond a shadow of a doubt that Accolade is a horse of class with staying power, proving his detractors wrong and giving his supporters much to cheer about.
And they're away and they're racing for the inaugural running of the Kingfisher Ultra Pune Derby. Accolade is the one moving up nicely on the outside. Four lengths behind is Germanica, but Volcan is now being pressed on the outside there by Accolade. Accolade with a crack or two. Volcan has dropped the rider. Then there's Germanica. There can't be a better tribute than this to the sire. Burden of Roof. Accolade does it in the Pune Derby from Germanica's Nam.
If there was one question mark over Accolade, it was his ability to stay the extra 400 meters. But with this win, Accolade proved himself to be a horse of class that is true of all Burden of Proof progeny. Burden of Proof, though himself only a sprinter miler, has a Stayers Cup winner in Arabian Prince. Desert God, Abs Fab, Snorpere, Sur La Tête, Agostini and New Alliance each have a Winter Classic over 2,400 meters under their belt. Burden of Proof passed away in August, but his legacy will continue on. He's a sure shot for champion sire this year with just another month to go. The exploits of Desert God and now Accolade have left their sire in a commanding position at the top of the table. These exploits have also made Carnegie Stud the champion stud farm, edging out Usha Stud, whose multidimensional had progeny dominating the classics thus far. This posthumous award will come after Burden of Proof was thwarted twice in 2012-13 and 2014-15, after Always a Rainbow staked his claim on the crown. It's all in a day's work for Accolade, whose victories have sealed his position as one of the top 3-year-olds in the country, Kunigal Stud's position as champion stud and Burden of Proof as champion sire. The General Rajendra Singh Ji Million, the feature event, has a small field, but forecasting the winner is a tough ask. Anteros has a good chance to come up trumps. He was seen finishing on very well to run winner after stick close. Now with extra galloping ground on offer, Anteros, who has won over a mile in Mumbai and with a run and mock under his belt as well, ought to be strongly fancied. Elegant Beauty from Malaysian Redu's yard looks a good prospect. She ran a decent fourth on her only run this season. She has been tracking well, and with Trevor to guide her, Elegant Beauty is the one to beat. Domination has had a good run while running third to Yana Raskala in the Jimmy Umrigar Trophy last week and should be able to shake off his maiden status when he lines up again. House of Commons looks set to finish off the season with a much-needed win. He was fancied last time out but probably needed the run when ending third to Pugnacious and Minstrel Heights, both of whom won again subsequently. That augurs well for the Faisal Abbas Cheney, and he should, in all probability, score his maiden win. Colombiana has been in good form all through the season and ought to end his Pune campaign on a high. He has been consistent all through and is in good shape to add another victory to his tally. And now for what's trending on social media. The IGCC Oktoberfest had the city of Pune in its grip as everyone turned up in their German best to celebrate the festival of beer and merrymaking. Derby weekend belonged to Accolade. However, there were celebrations all around as Anvil Star landed the Crown Plaza Pune Trophy Division 1 over 1,400 meters on the 15th, while Palatial, trained by Kuji Katrak, pocketed the IGCC trophy with a terrific stretch run without encountering any resistance with Neeraj Rawal in the saddle.
That's all we have for you in this episode of The Winning Post. Remember, if you missed anything at all, you can always catch it on our YouTube channel. Also, do follow Mohit Lalwani for his tips on Twitter. And we'll see you next week. Until then, goodbye and may the horse be with you.